here.
I'm like, what is that? It's the mic.
So, hey, everybody. My name is Asha Aylesbury. I'm from Nashville, Tennessee. I'm a junior computer engineering student. I'm trombone section leader, and I'm also recording secretary for Tau Beta Sigma.
It's about 7 o'clock, well, 7:05. I'm about to get up and start my day. It's Wednesday, November 1st, a big day, day before my birthday, so I'm pretty excited. I got 5 classes today, so I tend to, like, wake up super early to, like, get some homework done before time. So I'm about to, like, shower, brush my teeth, all that good stuff, and do some homework till I have class at 9. Yeah, so I'll check back with you then. I got in the shower and, like, brushed my teeth and all that stuff, and I, like, sat down to take this quiz for my engineering economy class. Didn't get a 100, so I'm probably going to take it again. Just because I try to keep my grade as high as I can in that class, because it's supposed to be, like, a really easy class, and it is, so why not make it 100? But I got an email that my 9 o'clock got canceled, which is really good, because I need some more time to do this homework. But also, it gives us more time to, like, study for the test, because we were supposed to have a test Friday, but now the test is Monday, so that's really good. So I'm just going to stay here a little bit longer, maybe wash a load of clothes, get some breakfast. But yeah, I'll check back with you when I'm heading to class.
Why'd you choose A&T?
I chose A&T because, for one, it was a HBCU, so I knew I wanted to go to a HBCU. Two, it had my major, which is very important because a lot of people overlook that. And three, when I was in high school, and even now, I'm still a really big band head, and they had a pretty decent band. They managed to win me over at Honda. So I was like, let me just go ahead and, you know, go to A&T and see what that's about. So that's why I went.
9:22, which is a little bit later than normal because my first class got canceled. But I'm about to head to engineering economy, which is basically like a, I don't know what kind of class it is, like maybe like a statistics class or like economics class. Pretty easy. It's the one I took the quiz for this morning. So I'm about to head there and I'll check back with you guys after that class.
What is a typical day like for you?
Very busy, and not necessarily just because, like, I don't want it to be busy, but I just have a million and one things to do. I like to stay busy just to stay as sharp and as focused as I can be. I wake up every morning around 7, Monday, Wednesday, Friday. I have 5 classes, 9 to 3, with a break at 12 for lunch. And Tuesday, Thursday, I have chem lab, which is about 3 hours. And then I have a electrical engineering lab, which is also about 3 hours. All right, so just like me, I forget to eat breakfast. So I'm trying to, like, go to my car and pick up one of the emergency, like, strawberry unfrosted Pop-Tarts. But I thought I parked in this parking lot, but I actually parked over there. So I have to kind of backtrack a little bit, but I gotta eat something so I'll be able to stay focused and alert during class. So yeah.
How is it as an engineering major?
Being an engineering major is pretty tough, but it's something that I personally wanted to do, so I don't mind doing all of the work that is required to be an engineering major, as far as like all these hard math classes or like just extra labs or just learning about stuff that not a lot of people know about, as far as like, okay, so I'm computer engineering and we have to take circuits and digital logic and microprocessors, which are all words that I didn't know what meant before I came to college. So, I mean, you have to learn a lot of new stuff, but if you're really passionate about what it is that you're doing, then like you won't have a problem doing that. But you also have to put in the effort and the hard work to be successful in an engineering field, so.
All right, so we in the same like algorithms class, which is my favorite class. And I was excited to go today because I knew he was gonna learn something. but it's canceled. So that means instead of 5 classes, I have 3 classes today, which I'm okay with because I get to do more of this homework that's due in 1, which I'm not quite finished with yet. But yeah, so another class canceled. God is good. Amen.
You missed all of band camp because of your internship. So tell me a bit about your intern experience.
My intern experience was really great. I would say that it was life-changing. Okay, so this summer I had the pleasure to intern with Microsoft. I know a lot of you haven't heard of that, but that's okay. So I'll tell you a little bit about it. I got the opportunity through the career fair that A&T puts on for all of its students, and I just went up to the booth, the Microsoft booth, and I gave them my resume. I didn't expect anything to come from it, but I got a call back, ended up getting an interview, and did well in interview, so I was able to go out and intern for the summer. I was exposed to a lot of different people and a lot of different things, a lot of different activities, but my biggest takeaway from it was to have this thing that they call a growth mindset, which is basically you can master whatever skill that you want to master. But as long as you keep a growth mindset, which is that you continuously want to do better in life, then the world is yours. So like that was my biggest takeaway from that. And it was a really great experience. Yeah, I was finally starting to see like all the benefits of my hard work in school over the years of like middle school, high school, college, all that good stuff. So it was very refreshing to just be like, okay, if you work hard, something can actually come of it. Cause you know, sometimes when you work hard, you're like, okay, well I'm working hard and I'm working, but I don't see nothing yet. But just to go out there and intern for them and learn all that I learned from them and be able to contribute to a company such as Microsoft was just a very great opportunity. So that was pretty nice.
It's pretty bright out here.
I'm about to head in my room and I'm probably gonna eat ramen for lunch so I can go ahead and knock out this homework and prepare for this quiz that I have at 1. Luckily the quiz in my last class was a take-home quiz, so I'm straight on that.
Being an out-of-state student, and knowing the additional expense associated with it, would you still consider coming to A&T?
Yes. Because you take a risk going out of state and having to pay more, but the reward is worth it. And I say the reward is worth it, even though I haven't quite got the reward yet. But you get a degree, which is phenomenal. And then also, you get all of these outside life experiences that you wouldn't necessarily have if you had gone to a college in-state. So like some other schools I was considering was like Vanderbilt, TSU, which are both in Tennessee and both very close to where I live. I would say within 10 to 15 minutes of where I live. And I pass by them every day going to high school. So I kind of know what's going on Vanderbilt's campus. I kind of know what's going on TSU's campus. And I was just looking for something that was fresh and new, school-wise and band-wise. And even though the cost is greater up front, I honestly feel like being here with the major that I do have and being successful in that major and just making sure like, okay, I'm here to get a degree, so I do that first. Like I've already kind of seen like, okay, this is kind of how my life could be. I could graduate with a job. I could financially support myself. And if I do have to take out a loan here or there or argue with financial aid maybe once or twice a semester to kind of get a couple hundred more dollars or whatever the case may be, like I can do that. And at the end, when I graduate and when I walk across the stage and get my diploma, I can be like, man, this was all worth it. So I feel like as long as you go somewhere, even if it's out of state, where you're going through your 4 years, your curriculum and all that stuff, and it's worth it, then the price that you rack up at the end, as long as you know you got a job to pay that off at the end, I mean, it's cool to me.
A couple minutes early, so now I'm about to head to chemistry, and it's just like general chemistry. I just waited to take it for whatever reason. But yeah, that class is really hard to focus into. I feel like all day I haven't thought about band, but like now I'm like starting to think about band, I guess, because it's a little bit closer to rehearsal. Rehearsal starts at 5 today. So after my chemistry class, I normally like get some food at the dome and go to my room, change clothes, and then head to practice and eat. So
being a first year section leader and first year member of Tau Beta Sigma, how do you manage the responsibilities?
It's tough.
All right, so I am at the band center. I got here a little early because I need to pick up my travel bag for when we go out of town this weekend. So yeah, I'm about to grab that right quick and then start getting ready for practice.
You really have to plan ahead. And when you plan ahead, don't get so set in your plan. Because being a first year section leader, I have 18 other people that I'm responsible for besides myself as far as band. Being a first year member of Tau Beta Sigma, you have all these other responsibilities as well. And a lot of the time, some of them overlap. So you really have to map out like, okay, so this day I'm gonna stay late to work on sectional stuff. All right, so you do that one day. And then, so your section has to stay late one day, right? And then, so the next day you're like, well, now I need to stay late to work on some Tau Beta Sigma stuff. So everybody in your Tau Beta Sigma circle stays late to help you out. But if you think about it, you have two groups of people which are heavily involved in. This one group stay late one day, this one group stay late the other day. But since you're in both groups, you stay late both days. So like sometimes it's like double work when you have to be responsible for your section and then also handle other duties. But if it's something that you're passionate about doing and you love doing it and you're willing to make sacrifices on, like, maybe I'll lose an hour of sleep here or whatever the case may be, if you want to see what you're involved in be great, it may be difficult at some times, but that difficulty never trumps the reward of just having something that you're a part of turn out absolutely amazing. Like, I don't know how else to describe it except that it is tough, but it's worth it. It's worth it because have you ever like started a project and then you're like, man, this is so hard, I'm about to give up. But then you don't give up and then you see it all the way to the end and you're just like, man, this is great. Why did I ever think about giving up? Like, that's kind of how I feel sometimes. So yeah.
Balance school, band, and everything else?
So I came in and I did this program called the Home Program. And in the Home Program, it takes in like incoming freshmen and gets them like acclimated to being an engineering major and also being in school. So I came, I think it was June 23rd. I'll never forget the day. It was about a month after I graduated high school. And you know, when you graduate, you're like, oh, I can't wait to get out the house. I'm just so ready. So I thought I was ready. And I got here and I didn't know anybody. And I was just kind of like, man, I'm kind of ready to go back home already. So I got here and I built a close bond with the other people that were in the home program with me. And it also helped me to get a leg up on figuring out how to balance band and school. Because I think the last week of that home program, which we were taking like a class, Calculus 1, and we did like professional development, like workshops and stuff throughout the day. But it really told me like, okay, if you want to be successful in your major and graduate with a job and also be in the band, like you have to realize that life is about choices. And every choice you make will have a consequence, whether you like the consequence or not. So coming in early really helped me to realize, okay, well, if I want to make an A in a class, I have to do the homework and I have to study. If I want to be great in band, I have to practice my music and I have to be at practice. And it really just showed me like, okay, so all the times that I think where I have, oh, I have an extra 30 minutes here or extra 30 minutes there, maybe sacrificing a nap or hanging out with some friends to get an assignment done, is totally worth it if you want to be successful in each avenue of life.
Being a female section leader in a male-dominated section, How do you go about keeping everything together?
This is a funny question. Just because, so I've noticed, and it very recently, probably like yesterday or the day before, because I was like, man, I think everything I do in life is male dominated. And it's not more males on earth than it is females, like half and half, maybe even less than half and half, like less males. But yeah, everything I do is pretty much male dominated. So I'm kind of used to people like looking at me as like the underdog, which I mean, can be a good and bad thing. Being an underdog, people underestimate you, which is kind of annoying. But at the same time, it's like you have something to prove. So it makes you work a little bit harder. As far as like keeping everything in order, I have to make sure that I have a personal connection with like everybody in my section. I have to make sure that I know like how everybody operates, what makes them very annoyed, like what are their pet peeves, what makes them like get excited, what makes them be aggressive, what makes them like work a little bit harder. And that's honestly the toughest part of being in a male dominated anything, trying to understand something that you may not necessarily be meant to understand, and just connecting to them. So by getting to know my section and getting to know what makes them tick and what makes them excited, I feel like over the course of the semester, I have really become like just a little bit better at motivating them and keeping them all in one mindset. Still a work in progress, but you know, you take it one day at a time and you learn from your mistakes and you keep on pushing.
All right, last question. What do you want your legacy to be as a member of the BGMM?
My legacy as a member of the BGMM, it's not so much focused on like what I want to do that people can relate my name back to, but more so like, all right, so we see some things that the program can do better. We see how we want to grow in numbers and musicianship and all that good stuff. And I just want to leave behind the idea that if you want something, don't be afraid to work hard for it, even when things get tough. Just because things will get tough in life and in band and in school. But if every time something gets tough, you give up, you'll never accomplish anything. So just to keep pushing in the absolute toughest, longest, latest hour is something that I want to leave behind. And also just continue to grow. If you set a goal and you reach that goal, set another goal. If you reach that goal, set another goal. Never stop growing and always continue to push through any struggle, battle, circumstance you encounter.